Hare Krishna. For God, no problem is too big or too small. When we face problems in life, we try our best to deal with the problems. But when we are not able to deal, sometimes we may seek the help of someone more powerful than us. And that can be God. Sometimes circumstantially we look for someone who can help us. But the circumstances are such that nobody seems to be able to help us, then we turn towards God. And when we face problems, that is often an impetus for us to direct our consciousness towards God. So when we want to focus on Krishna, when we want to call out to Krishna, when we want to connect to Krishna, problems often become the impetuses. And Krishna talks about this in the Bhagavad-Gita in 7.16. when he says that people facing problems are prominent among those who come to him. Chaturvidha bhajante mam jana sukritno arjuna arto jigyasur arthaarthi jnani cha bharatarshaba. Those who have a problem that they don't have wealth, those who have a problem, they are distressed because of that. They come to Krishna. There are two categories of people. So now when we want to approach Krishna, is it that when the problem is very big, there should be a particular parameter. The problem is this big, then I'll approach Krishna. The small problem, I'll take care of it myself. Sometimes I feel this problem is so big that even Krishna can't solve it. But the fact is, Krishna is bigger than the biggest problem that we may have. He exhibits his majestic Virat Rupa. He's far, far bigger than all the warriors that Arjuna was facing on the Kurukshetra battlefield. He is the supreme being within whom all of existence is present. So no problem is too big for him. When we have to meditate on Krishna, when we have to remember Krishna, in the 8th chapter, it is said, Kavim Puranam Anushasitaram Anoranuyam Samanusmaredya Sarvasya Dhataram Achintya Rupam Aditya Varanam Tamasa Parastad. So Krishna has told in the previous verses, always think of me, Tasmat Sarveshu Kaleshu Mamanusmar Yuddhacha. 8.7. Now he is saying how to remember him constantly. And he says two attributes. Anoraniyamsa, he is smaller than the smallest. And then he says Sarvasya Dhataram, he is the sustainer of all of existence. That means he is omnipotent, he is all great. He is all powerful. So Krishna is greater than the greatest, smaller than the smallest. Anoraniyamsa mahato mahiyan. Understanding this, even the smallest of problems, it becomes a thought for us to remember Krishna. Then that is auspicious. Now of course, when we remember Krishna, we don't demand that Krishna intervene and help us solve that problem. Or we just want to remember Krishna, pray to Krishna. Krishna, in every situation, let me remember that I am your servant. Let me serve you always. So for the smallest agitation that might be there in our heart, smallest anxiety, Krishna is present in our hearts and he can deal with that. He is conscious of that. And the huge problems, catastrophic problems might come in our life and Krishna is bigger than them also. So rather than worrying about the size of the problem, we can focus on the direction of our consciousness. So whatever be the problem, whether small or big or even no problem, if we become conscious of Krishna, then we are always in the path of auspiciousness. And Krishna will guide us to deal with all problems, small and big. Machitta sarva durgani mat prasada tarishasi. Krishna says, if you become conscious of me, you will pass over all problems. Sarva Durgani, he says. He doesn't say only big problems. He says all problems, small or big. So rather than being problem conscious and being conscious of the size of problems, let us be Krishna conscious always. Striving to have a mood of service to him, and all problems, small and big, Krishna will guide us to face them and grow through them. Thank you. Hare Krishna.